Hello students, hope we are enjoying your study at home and we are very happy to see your support. Keep studying and keep liking us. In the previous video, we discussed about the process of pollination, its type and some characteristic feature by which plant supports self-pollination. Now in this video, we will study about the cross-pollination. Cross-pollination, as you know, is the process by which the pollen grains from the anther of the one plant or one flower reach to the stigma of another flower that is on another plant. That process is known as cross-pollination. By supporting the cross-pollination, some different agency or some different agents are required. Means cross-pollination tabhi ho sakta hai jab koi agent support kare ki pollen grains ko ek jagah se carry karke dusri jagah pe transfer kar sake. कौन कौन से एजेंट्स हो सकते हैं उनके बेसिस पे हमने डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ क्रॉस पॉलिनेशन देखा था प्रीवियस वीडियो के अंदर लाइक एनिमोफिली इन विच एयर इज यूज एज अ पॉलिनेटिंग एजेंट. सेकेंड वन इज हाइड्रोफिली इन विच वाटर इज यूज एज अ पॉलिनेटिंग एजेंट. थर्ड वन वॉज द जूफिली इन विच एनिमल्स आर यूज एज अ पॉलिनेटिंग एजेंट. नेक्स्ट एंटेमोफिली इन विच इंसेक्ट्स आर यूज एज अ पॉलिनेटिंग एजेंट. एंड नेक्स्ट इज ऑर्निथोफिली इन विच birds are used as a pollinating agents for the transfer of pollen grains. Now let's discuss one by one these types of cross pollination and the characteristics of the flower which support this pollination. Let's start with the first one, that is anemophily. Anemophily is the pollination by wind or by air. For doing pollination by wind, plants have the flower have some characteristic feature. Like first characteristic feature that we can see that the flowers should be small in size and they are not showy. First characteristic that is flowers small in size and not showy. This is the characteristics by which flowers support anemophily. They are small in size and they are not showy. Size chota hota hai taki asani se wind pollination ho sake, anthers asani se ek stigma ke upar aake capture ho sake. And second thing that is they are not showy. Means flowers are not looks beautiful. Yahan pe insects ko attract karne jaisa koi bhi kaam nahi karna taki पॉलिनेशन हो सके. कोई इंसेक्ट की अट्रैक्शन नहीं हो रही इसलिए फ्लावर्स को सुंदर दिखने के लिए कोई जरूरत नहीं होती. सो सच टाइप ऑफ फ्लावर्स आर नॉट शोई इन नेचर. सेकंड कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स दैट इज रिक्वायर्ड फॉर द एनिमोफिली इज द सेंट एंड नेक्टर्स. द सेंट एंड नेक्टर्स आर ऑल्सो नॉट फॉर्म्ड. The flowers which support anemophily in such type of flowers, scent and nectars are also not formed because this is not required. As the same kind, insects are not coming for the pollination, insects are not required, then why should the flowers produce nectars? Why should present form the fragrance? इस चीज की उनको जरूरत नहीं होती क्योंकि उन्हें इंसेक्ट्स को अट्रैक्ट नहीं करना. सो सेंट एंड नेक्टर्स आर ऑल्सो नॉट फॉर्म्ड इन सच टाइप ऑफ फ्लावर्स फॉर द पॉलिनेशन. नेक्स्ट थर्ड कैटेगरी या थर्ड इंपॉर्टेंट कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स इज द लार्ज क्वांटिटी ऑफ पॉलन ग्रेन्स आर फॉर्म्ड. लार्ज क्वांटिटी ऑफ पॉलन ग्रेन्स आर फॉर्म्ड इन सब टाइप ऑफ फ्लावर. इन सम फ्लावर्स विच सपोर्टिंग एनिमोफिली पॉलन ग्रेन्स आर फॉर्म्ड इन वेरी लार्ज अमाउंट सो दैट द चांसेस ऑफ क्रॉस पॉलिनेशन कैन बी इंक्रीज. द एग्जाम्पल ऑफ सच टाइप ऑफ फ्लावर इज कैनाबिस. कैनाबिस इज अ फ्लावर इन विच द पॉलन ग्रेन्स इज फॉर्म्ड इन द ऑलमोस्ट 5 lakhs अराउंड पॉलन ग्रेन्स आर फॉर्म्ड फॉर एनिमोफिली. If this is happens so that the chances of cross pollination can be increased. What happens here that like when air is using as a pollinating agent, air ke through pollen grains move hoke ja rahe hain to ye koi zaruri nahi hai ki sabhi ke sabhi pollen grains kisi stigma tak pahunch paye. Is cheez ko ensure karne ke liye flower jo hai pollen grains bahut large amount mein bana rahe hain ki kuch to कुछ तो पहुंचेंगे दूसरे स्टिग्मा तक, चांसेस तो इंक्रीज होंगे. सो दैट टू इंक्रीज द पॉसिबिलिटी ऑफ पॉलिनेशन द फ्लावर्स फॉर्म पॉलन ग्रेन्स इन अ वेरी लार्ज क्वांटिटी. फोर्थ करैक्टरिस्टिक्स दैट इज प्रेजेंट इन द फ्लावर्स दैट दे आर ड्राई एंड अनवेटेबल. ड्राई एंड अनवेटेबल. Pollen grains which are forming in such type of flowers, they are dry and unwettable, means they do not get wet by the water and any other things. If they get wetted, then they will become heavy and they will settle down. They will not able to fly with the air. अगर pollen grain गीले हो जाएंगे किसी चीज से तो वो heavy हो जाएंगे और heavy होने की वजह से नीचे settle हो जाएंगे और air के साथ fly नहीं कर पाएंगे. So they remain dry and unwettable, so they can easily fly with the air or by the wind. Next, plants grow in a large group. In such type of flowers, the plants grow in large group. The flowers which are supporting anemophily, they produce in such a manner that many plants are growing in a group, and the groups are also very large in amount. So that the pollen grains which are coming from the air can be received by any stigma. अगर groups में नहीं होंगे flower दूर दूर होंगे तो chances कम हो जाएंगे कि pollen grains को receive कर पाए. And when the all the plants are remain in a group, then chances can be increased to receive the pollen grains for the pollination. So this is one more characteristic. Next thing, next important characteristics we will discuss, that is about the stigma. Stigma of the such flowers which are supporting anemophily, in such type of flowers, stigma should be sticky. Stigma should be large, or we can say well exposed, large, sticky, hairy and feathery. The flowers which are formed for the crop. Anemophily, in such type of flowers, stigmas are large or well exposed, sticky, hairy and feathery, so that they can easily capture the pollen grains. अगर stigma size में ऊंची होगी, size बड़ा होगा, तो वह आसानी से air के साथ आने वाले pollen grains को capture कर पाएगी. Same thing is for the sticky nature. अगर sticky होगी, तो pollen grains can easily get attached with that stigma. And it has hairy or feathers like appearance. अगर उसमें hairs or feathers like appearance होंगी, so stigma is able to capture the pollen grains which are flying in the air. So this is the important characteristics related with the stigma for favoring anemophily. Next important characteristics, that is explosion method or explosive mechanism. The flowers which are supporting anemophily, in such type of flowers, anthers burst with the explosive mechanism. When anther get matured and pollen grains are ready to be released, at that time anthers burst with an explosion, and by this explosion the pollen grains are spreaded at larger distance. अचानक जैसे ही कोई भी चीज burst होती है, bomb explode होता है, like same thing, जब anther ready हो जाते हैं, anther mature हो जाते हैं, pollen grains ready हैं release होने के लिए, anther एकदम explosion के साथ burst होंगे और pollen grains दूर तक spread हो जाते हैं air के अंदर, and then they can easily fly with the air. This is one more adaptive feature. Next is eighth feature, that is well exposed stamens. Well exposed stamen. The flowers which are using air as a pollinating agent, they have stamens which are well exposed. Well exposed means, like if one flower has stamen, this is the female part and these are the stamens, and here anthers are present. If these anthers are present inside the flower or inside the petals, they are covered inside the petals, then they are not able to fly with the air. So the length of the filament should be large and they have to be exposed in the air, so that when they burst and the pollen grains get released, they can easily come in the contact of air. Agar yahan pe ye jo stamens hain, इनका साइज बड़ा नहीं होगा, फिलामेंट का साइज बड़ा नहीं होगा और ये नीचे होंगे, इनकी लेंथ कम होगी फिलामेंट्स की। तो ये पॉलन ग्रेन्स जब एंथर से रिलीज हुए तो ये एयर के कॉन्टेक्ट में आ पाए, इस चीज के चांसेस बहुत कम हो जाते हैं। सो टू इंक्रीज द पॉसिबिलिटी ऑफ रिलीज ऑफ दीज पॉलन ग्रेन्स इन एयर, दीज स्टैमेन शुड हैव द लार्ज और वेल एक्सपोज्ड कंडीशन। सो दिस इज द नेक्स्ट कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स बाय विच विंड पॉलिनेशन कैन बी डन, दैट इज दे हैव वेल एक्सपोज्ड स्टैमेन। नेक्स्ट कैरेक्टरिस्टिक दैट इज नाइन्थ कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स, they have numerous flowers are present in an in one inflorescence, numerous flowers are in inflorescence means when we can we are able when we see any flower, this flower is not a single flower, this is the combination of many flowers in some plants and this is known as inflorescence. In one inflorescence many flowers are grouped together so that the chances of the anemophily can be increased. So we discovered some important characteristics features by which the plants favor the anemophily. Now we will discuss take a look on the examples of the such type of plants which supports anemophily. The examples are wheat, rice, maize and grasses. And the grasses, these are the some examples of the plants which supports anemophily. Here one more thing, one more example is there, that is the example of corn cob. Corn cob that we used to eat, that corn cob in which we see some tassels like structure, we see some tassels like structure, these tassels like that is long hairy structure, these are the tassels. These tassels are actually stigma and style of the flower. This corn cob is the flower and these tassels which comes from these flowers are actually the stigma and style. So this is also an important example in which stigma and style form tassels and these tassels are formed for capturing the pollen grains. Now let's take a look what the characteristic feature we discussed so far. First, flowers are small in size and they are not showing, flower ka size chota hoga, dekhne mein sundar nahi hote, they are not showing. Second, they do not need to produce scent and nectar. Third, flowers form pollen grains in a large quantity so that chances of anemophily can be increased. Fourth, pollen grains are dry and unwettable. नेक्स्ट, प्लांट्स ग्रो इन लार्ज ग्रुप्स, प्लांट्स जो होते हैं वो एक लार्ज ग्रुप के अंदर प्रोड्यूस होंगे. नेक्स्ट, स्टिग्मा इज लार्ज स्टिकी हेयरी एंड फिदरी, इन सच फ्लावर्स द स्टिग्मा इज लार्ज हेयरी एंड फिदरी सो दैट इट कैन इजिली अटैच्ड, इट कैन इजिली कैप्चर द पॉलन ग्रेन्स. नेक्स्ट, फ्लावर्स यूज एक्सक्लूसिव मैकेनिज्म फॉर द रिलीज ऑफ पॉलन ग्रेन्स फ्रॉम द एंथर. नेक्स्ट कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स, वेल एक्सपोज स्टेमेंस आर found in the such type of flowers. Next characteristics is numerous flowers are formed in one inflorescence and the example of such type of flowers are wheat, rice, maize and some grasses. And next we discuss about the corn cob. Corn cob have hair like appearance, hair like structure that are the tassels and these tassels are actually stigma and style of that flower which is for the cross pollination or for capturing the pollen grains which are coming with the air. So that's what the characteristics for the flower which supports anemophily. After this, in the next video we study about the some characteristics feature for the hydrophily. Thanks